Hey guys, Tom here from FXhome, and today we're looking at how to get your webcam footage looking like this to this. With many of us now working from home, it's important to keep a level of professionalism in your setups, whether it be for live streams, podcasts, presentations, or just catching up with your nan. We're going to be doing this by going over some household items that you already have access to enhance your footage, as well as going over a couple of accessories to enhance the quality. This will be a step-by-step process so you can see how we actually managed to get to this result. But before anything, if you could hit the subscribe button and ring the bell icon, it really helps out the channel and lets us know that you're having a good time. So this is probably familiar, right? The angle, the view, the quality, it's all wrong. It's terrible. Right now, I'm working with a laptop's webcam. So how on earth do we start making this look better? Well, number one is the angle. You don't want to look up my nose. I don't want you to look up my nose. This angle is even more unflattering when you're working in complete darkness, illuminated by the screen light. You look like you're out of a horror film. All good portraits should be eye level, and here is no exception. This can easily be sorted with the help of a laptop stand, a couple of books, or a box if you have one lying around the house. Now that we're eye line, we need to create some depth between myself and the background. Right now, I am way too close to this wall, and it's not really doing anything in terms of the shot. I feel like we can create a bit more depth between myself and the background, and that'll help out our entire lighting process. So I'm actually gonna rotate my setup round. Come have a journey with me. We're gonna rotate around, round. Yeah, that looks a bit better. I didn't plan this at all. This is much better and clearly has a lot more space in it. This is definitely looking a lot nicer and a bit more professional, but not to sound like your mum, but clean your room. We may be stuck inside, but we don't want the person on the receiving end of a phone call or presentation to think that we're a bit messy. Might give the wrong impression. This is a tip, so I'm gonna clean it now.
Time, lots of time, having a great time, having a great time, cleaning this room.
Much better. Right now we're looking a lot better than what we were, but we're very flat and a bit lifeless, to be honest. We need to create some contrast and separation between myself and the background. One of the first things that I'm going to be adding, ooh god, what's this one?
Oh Tom, you really fudged this one up.
The first thing we can do to enhance the quality of this image is introduce a new light. This light is just going to sit by my desktop and be able to act as a thing. That's looking a little bit bright, so I might turn that down just a touch. Lovely. Without. Now I know what you're thinking, I don't have a ring light. A nice simple alternative to the ring light is to actually increase the brightness of your monitor or introduce a desk lamp. Does the same thing. All you're doing with this technique is just adding some light onto your subject so your webcam can do its thing and there's no problems. At the moment, there is no daylight coming into the scene, but there is a very large window beside me. If there was a large amount of light coming into this, if I redirected myself to face that window and allowed that daylight to come through, it would do the same thing as the ring light. Embrace the light and it shall guide the way. Another thing that I've done is add this practical light in the background. This is a really nice way to bring some atmosphere and depth to your scene and also creates a little bit of divide between myself and the background. That way you're not blending all into one. Now for the purposes of this tutorial being bearable, I am using an external mic. If I was to switch to the built-in one, I sound a little bit crackly. It becomes even worse when I start typing. To neaten this up and avoid bothering anybody else that may be in the room, we can throw on a set of headphones. Headphones like these ones are perfect because of where the mic is actually sitting. It's in a great position where I can be moving around and doing things and it's still going to be right by my mouth. As opposed to the built-in mic where if I was to be moving away back and forth, you can hear my audio displacement. The one thing to keep an eye on, however, is this rubbing up against any clothing or press we've been restricted by whatever the laptop actually comes with, which is the default things. In most cases, this is a HD 1080p webcam, but there are a couple of external accessories that we can add to heighten the quality and the result of our image. A first obvious option is an external webcam. These are easy USB plug-in options that can now come in up to 4K resolution. But if 4K sounds like too much for what you need, then you can actually use your phone as a webcam. Apps like Epoch Cam can link with your computer or laptop. With most phones these days, you're looking at a 4K camera with a fantastic result. For things like podcasts and everything else in between, a Blue Yeti mic is a simple solution for clean audio, as they can simply plug in via USB and immediately improve your sound quality. Lastly, if you do have access to a DSLR, you can link this up by using a cam link. These adapters are usually pretty pricey, but allow you to stream with the quality of your DSLR. Thank you for watching this tutorial. If you have found something useful, please do hit the like button and subscribe if you haven't already. And let us know in the comment section down below what you are planning to use these tips for. Presentation, calling Nan, let us know. Thank you again for watching this tutorial, and we will see you next time. How do I hang up?